some of their lives and their future and what wealth they have in the area, but it also allows to the wider area of the Wirral that here you as a council want to defend, wish to distinguish by making areas conservation areas. How are these sorts of piecemeal applications for changing the very nature of a building compatible with that long-term objective when you first came to designating it as a conservation area? A decision, of course, which I very much support. Thank you very much, Chair.
Thank you. Can I open this up to committee? Pat?
States that we should only be allowing developments that preserve or enhance the conservation area.
Thank you, Paul. Treena? Thanks, Chair. Unfortunately, I didn't get to come on site visit. We do have to listen to the local residents. We do have to listen to the local councillor and the local MP. You know, these are the local people who are feeling the impact of this development and the impact that it'll have.
schemes, if there will be an impact, therefore, on the highways. It is a conservation area which we should be protecting, and I do see this as overdevelopment. Thanks, Chair.
Thank you, Treena. If nobody else wants to speak, could I ask Councillor Cleary to move for reason to be refusal, please? Do we actually have anybody here for the sixth item on the agenda, Co Operative Pharmacy? If not, can I propose that we actually move, where there are people here for agenda item 8, we can move that forward. Would that be okay with the committee? Okay, so we're going to move now to agenda item 8, which is Rullerton Road, which is pages 49 to 52 on the agenda. Can we have the presentation, please?
Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Chair. This application was referred from the Planning Committee earlier this month to allow members to visit the site. The application is for construction of a two-storey pitched roof extension to the rear of the property. The main issues to assess in relation to this application is compliance with both national and local planning policy, and the impact of the proposal on the residential amenities of surrounding occupiers. Unit Development Plan Policy H11 specifies that when assessing proposals for two-storey rear extensions, such proposals should not be closer than 2.5 metres to the property boundary and 1 metre to any other boundary. This proposed extension will project out from the main rear wall of the dwelling by 2.47 metres and will be sited 3.4 metres away from the party boundary with number 79 and 2 metres from the side boundary with number 83. It's therefore considered that the proposed extension complies with policy HS11 and should not therefore have a detrimental impact on the residential amenities of the surrounding occupiers and is therefore recommended for approval.
Thank you. Is there a ward councillor would like to speak on this? Would you like to come forward? You could just state your name for the vote, please.
Firstly, I'd like to thank the committee for attending the site visit at 81 Wallasey Road, LISCARD, on the 20th of June. And would like to address the following issues and concerns on behalf of residents who are here tonight and other residents who couldn't attend. I do beg your indulgence as the objections and concerns are lengthy and detailed, but I do feel I owe it to the residents who read them out to you. Thank you. Firstly, we have the height of the building, which is 6,980 millimetres. The original site visit did not obtain access to the rear of the property at 81, so all testing was obtained via plans. How accurate is this, my residents would like to know. As the height of the proposed build will result in the loss of light to habitable rooms on the drive to the rear of the property at 83, along with the shadowing patio area at 79. Also, the plan stated a scale of 1.5, therefore, was all the original testing done based on the build being 1.5 and 2.5. So, these are concerns about the dimensions, and I think they have been brought to the officer's attention prior to 0.75 millimetres. Whilst this was drawn out at the site visit, we feel the sketch distracted from all present in the actual height of the build and the 45-degree test, which is our main concern. Could you clarify if this has been done correctly, please? The distance from the rear extension to their garage is not 2 metres as stated as a minimum requirement on the agenda. The measured distance is 1.7 to 1.8 metres. Has this been measured on residents' right to know? The agenda states that the garage will remain, however, it is noted there will be no planning permission required to demolish the building. We have taken on board that this does not form part of this application, but we would like to voice our concerns tonight. I would like to know how this will affect the structure to my boundary wall, adjoining to my garage, and the alterations to rear access at 81. This is from my resident to 81 Wilson Road. The proximity to 83 Wilson Road boundary is 2.1 metres as opposed to 2.2 as stated on the agenda. This results in a view from my rear side door being 6980 × 2475. This is not considering the roof height, which will also impact on our right to light. This is the same for 79 Wallasey Road, albeit the distance between the properties being greater. The proposed build is not in keeping with the area. At the site visit, we felt that visiting the neighbouring properties would have been beneficial to get an overview and feel for the surrounding properties, thus appreciating the effects this build will have on all our properties. Our properties were built in 1924 with a mix of semi-detached, detached and bungalow properties, none of which are directly overlooked due to the design of our gardens. We have no properties that have had a two-storey extension in the vicinity. We don't want to set a precedent. I must stress that there hasn't been any similar builds to this, so this would be the first one. A loss of privacy is a big concern here. Due to the proximity of the proposed build, the dimensions that affect our rear gardens, it will result in a loss of privacy and the rear windows to the first floor of the proposed build, protruding further down our gardens. So what we've got here is a loss of privacy to adjoining gardens either side of the proposed build, which I must say I did attend both properties either side with Councillor Bernie, and we could understand how that would be, the loss of privacy being overlooked either side into it's summer, people are out in the gardens, they're relaxing the sunbathing, and they would definitely be overlooked by this. Land levels. The land levels highlighted in our objection letters have not been addressed or tested as to the effects of the right to light at 83 Rollerton Road. As previously mentioned, the descent of the road, 83 Rollerton Road, is on the lower ground to that of 81 Rollerton Road, thus making the proposed height of the field larger than stated, resulting in overshadowing. We'd like to know if any tests have been applied in this instance. Disturbances, in addition to all the above the proposed build, will cause an enormous amount of noise and dust to surrounding properties. If this gets passed, which we hope it doesn't, we would like restrictions to building work and that no work will be carried out at 5 o'clock on weekdays or carried out on weekends and bank holidays. We've hit the summer months and a time when family and friends enjoy the south-facing gardens. I hope this will be taken into consideration. In addition, neighbours have washing to be dried and the last thing they want is to be covered in building dust materials. Also, a neighbouring property fosters babies and toddlers, so the last thing they need is dust, dirt and noise that comes with such a build. Finally, I'd like to state the effects this proposed build has had on me and my neighbour tonight. It's put a lot of strain and pressure on our resident busy lives, let alone the upset. Instead of coming round and relaxing, coming home and relaxing, we've had to spend time defending our objections without any consultation. We were firstly shocked and astounded that someone applied for planning permission prior to purchasing the property. There's been no communication from the code advisors, now owners. Having moved in just under 2 weeks ago, we have still not been approached to have any type of discussion regarding the proposed plans. Planning recommendations state to approach neighbours prior to applying for planning permission. Surely this is a common courtesy. When purchasing a property, it's hard to find everything you want. For instance, there has to be a compromise somewhere, as difficult as it is in Wallasey to find a property that has a large, habitable home and a good-sized garden. Speaking from personal experience, we moved for a south-facing garden and garage for our children to enjoy. We could not find a house with the same size bedrooms and more kitchen, but we compromised. appreciate that people want to improve their homes, and there are alternatives to the current two-storey build. My residents of Wallasey City have no objections to the ground floor build. Going up to the first floor have a devastating effect on their lives, on their right to light and privacy. We do fully understand, however, that this application before tonight is what it is, and it would neither approve nor reject, and not modified in any way, shape or form. We followed all planning procedures and would be grateful if the planning committee could consider all of our six objections, issues and concerns. If so, can we suggest that the owners of 81 months and no revise their proposed plans? We understand that that's not possible at this time. But I'd just like to say that I have had, and Councillor Mooney has had, a loss of contact with the residents that are here tonight, and this has had a massive and detrimental effect on their lives in terms of worrying about what might happen in the future, how they'll be overlooked. And I can just like to say that I think this is an application that there's no precedent for, and I think it would be in the character of the road, as well as have an effect on the residents, the immediate side to the building in question. Thank you.
Thank you. Can I just draw members' attention to the late list, and a lot of these points are actually additional comments are actually on the late list. Could I ask the officers to clarify some of the points before I open it up to committee in terms of size, roof height, loss of privacy of guard panels and walls and lighting in the room in particular?
Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Chair. The submitted application is going to an electric scale. On the scale of the submitted drawings, the total height to the ridge of the extension is 6.8 metres. The total height to the existing roof is 9 metres, and it would be 5.6 metres to the eaves. The proposed extension doesn't contain any side windows, only rear windows at ground and first floor level. In terms of the impact on the existing garage, the garage doesn't require planning permission for its removal, so even if there wasn't an extension there, the applicants could remove their garage without consulting with the local planning authority. The case officer did what's called a 45 degree angle for the proposed extension, which shows there shouldn't be any loss of light through this extension to both the ground and first floor main windows of the two Franklin properties.
Can I open this up to committee?
Chair.
Steve.
Thank you, Chair. I do feel the neighbours, and I think one of the points that I've made, and I've always done this type of extension before, it might be that doesn't make any relevance for someone to have done it before. And I think the group, first line trained by the planning is approval.
Chair, through you, Chair. We wouldn't normally apply such a condition limiting the hours of operation because it's dealt with under different legislation, but what we can ask for is a construction management plan which should be set out the hours that the builders, if members are minded to approve the application, should work. That way we can enforce against that construction management plan more easily.
Denise? Is there anybody else who wants to speak on this before we go to the vote?
Just to clarify then, we can have those conditions put on.
Yeah.
Okay, if you could please, yeah.
Okay, so Cathy's moved approval subject to the conditions listed and the additional condition in relation to the construction management plan. And Denise has seconded that. Can we go to the vote, please? All those in favour of approval. Unanimous. If we can now go back to agenda item 6, which I missed out earlier, which is pages 21 to 28. Can we have a presentation, please?
Thank you, Chair. This application is for the demolition of an existing single-storey building and the erection in its place of a three-storey mixed-use building. The site is on the corner of Village Road in Heswall and Rainy Close, which is a private road in the Lower Heswall Conservation Area. The surrounding uses are a mixture of residential uses and commercial uses, with houses being opposite the site immediately, but also some shops and such commercial uses opposite too. The adjoining property to the application site, 2224, is a three-storey property. It was originally, a long time ago, part of a pair of semi-detached three-storey properties on both sides. The proposal before us tonight is a three-storey building. The ground floor is proposed as a restaurant, and there are two flats proposed at first and second floor. The second floor flat also uses part of the roof space for accommodation and has a balcony in the rear of the site. The building scale is similar to the building next door in that it has a very similar rear building ladder, although the higher element projects a slightly further forward, the three-storey element of the building next door. So the building itself, it seeks to complement the adjoining building. It's got a three-storey gable, which is similar in scale and design to the building that will be joined onto on Village Road. The rear end of the building is Realey Close as it drops down to Realey Close. Goes down to two-storey and then single-storey at the back of the site. The ground floor A3 use has its main entrance on Village Road on the front, but it also has a side entrance on Rainy Close. The flats take their entrance from the back of the site and come in through Rainy Close, and there are two parking spaces proposed between the end of the building and the nearest garage of the next property on Rainy Close, one Rainy Close, and two parking spaces proposed there. As the other flat also uses a roof space as a balcony, which projects out to the rear, we feel this is a sufficient distance from all the properties nearby to mitigate any overlooking. But to either side, just to make sure there's no overlooking side, there is a glazed screen, which will be glazed up to 1.7 metres, so there shouldn't be any overlooking to each side of the balcony as well. The building itself, it's mainly brick, would have a slate roof and some planning panelling within the design of the building. It's trying to fit in with the conservation, but give it a more twist as well. We feel it makes a positive contribution to the conservation area, more so than the single storey building on site at the moment, and it is recommended for approval. I would just like to draw your attention, if members are minded to approve this application, because there's a late notification because the adjacent road is a private road, that means that the period runs until the 28th of June, so we couldn't issue a decision notice until after the 28th of June, assuming that there are no further objections received from the trade and communities.
Okay, could I just ask you to put the
CSR planning applications decided under delegated powers between the 21st of May and the 11th of June 2017. Are there any comments we have to move those? Okay, happy to accept? Okay, thank you. I don't have any other urgent business other to let you know that the site visit will be on the 18th of July. So you can put that in your diaries and we'll send some notification out to as to the arrangements on. Okay, well thank you very much for your attention and contribution.